What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Trey Sense here. Got a quick little video I'm gonna do for you today, and today is five fragrances from the Cheapie house of Perry Ellis that I think you guys should know about. All right, no further ado, let's get right into it. Some of these you may already know, and some of them you may not, but for those who don't, this is Perry Ellis White, and this is a very nice smelling fragrance. To me, it's very masculine, very upscale, very elegant at the same time, and very much a clone of Lemon. I like the way this smells, and honestly, I have never not worn this fragrance and gotten a compliment. Every time I put it on, I get a compliment. Great smelling fragrance. It's one of the least, get this notification off, it's one of the least talked about fragrances from this house. But I think that is a great smelling fragrance. Again, you can get 100 ml of this when you can find it easily, or either under or around the $20 mark. I suggest you get the 100 ml if you can. You can also get the 50 ml 1.7, and it's going to come in just over $14, $15. That's Perry Ellis White. It's a Lamal clone, a nice, powdery, clean fragrance. Great for this time of the year. Good for a date night. I think it's a versatile fragrance. I think you can wear it in the summer or the winter, fall, whenever. It's so inexpensive. You can wear it doing anything that you need to do. But I think if you wore it on a date or something like that, somebody would think you spent a lot of money on a fragrance and would be highly impressed. That's just my opinion on it. That's Perry Ellis 360 White. Another one from the 360 collection, and that's Perry Ellis 360 collection is what it says. I thought this was NAR. It may be NAR, but I don't see it on the bottle. So we're just gonna go with Perry Ellis 360. I've worn this a few times, and again, this is a nice fragrance. To me, a lot of the cheaper fragrance houses, in my opinion, honestly, yeah, that's a nice, smooth, romantic fragrance. I like it a lot. Very versatile. It's not very strong. This, I think, would be good for an office. And I think I paid around $17 for this. And I think it's the 50 mil. I can't really see it because this writing is so small. But I want to say it's the 50 mil, 1.7 ounce. Yeah. It smells like something, though, which most of the house of Perry Ellis is a cheapy house. But it's definitely a clone house as well. And I wish I could tell you what this is cloning, but I can't. But again, that's 360 collection from the house of Perry Ellis. If you see this and you're looking for a very safe, laid back, casual, but nice, refined, cheapy, I think this is it. I think this would make a good office scent or a great close encounter scent because it's just not loud, it's not offensive, it's not a projection monster, it's not a longevity monster. It's just a nice, close encounter, casual type of fragrance that I think smells good that can be had under $20. One last time, Perry Ellis 360 collection. I thought it was NAR, but I'm not sure. Another one from the house of Perry Ellis that I think is very underrated. It is Perry Ellis Reserve. And of course, these are all from the 360 line or whatever. But, and I like this one a lot as well. This is one I've had, I think this is my second bottle of this one. Yeah. And this is a nice, again, masculine. This is definitely a stronger projector, stronger performer than the 360. I just showed you the collection. Definitely a stronger performer than this one. This one is, again, it's a nice, smooth, masculine fragrance. A little bit green, a little bit spicy. I think it would be great. Man, it smells good. For this time of the year, Perry Ellis is one of my favorite houses. Nobody talks about it a lot. And I think it's because it's, you know, basically, let's call it what it is. It's a clone house. A lot of their fragrances are clones and inexpensive, and that just, I guess, turns people off. But if you're looking for some really good cheapies, that smells nice. Perry Ellis is a great house to start. This smells, I will say it's a bit cologne-y, if you know what I mean by that. If you don't, I'll try to explain. It does have a general I guess the best word would be generic. I just say cologne. It has a very generic smell to it. But it does smell good. It smells better than the average cheap cologne, in my opinion. Though it does smell basic, I don't think anybody will confuse it and think that you smell cheap. And that is a big difference. Pick up on a little bit of mint in there or something. I don't know. It just smells good. It smells reserved is a good word for it. Nice fragrance. I like it a lot. 50 mil, and I think this is around $12. And that's Perry Ellis Reserve. All right, one that I've had in my collection for a long time, and I like it a lot, and I know it is a cologne. Great smelling fragrance. This is Perry Ellis Portfolio Green, and this is a knockoff of, or dupe, or whatever you want to call it, clone, carbon copy of, man, y'all. If you are a fan of Dolce & Gabbana, the original, the little funny looking bottle with the sticker on it, the old school vibe. This stuff right here, and I have to be honest, this right here, this fragrance right here is what led me to buying inexpensive fragrances on the regular. Because I had the Dolce & Gabbana, which I paid a lot of money for it at the time, and then I blind bought this, and I kept sniffing, and I'm going, this smells like something that I already have, but I like it. And then I realized it was Dolce & Gabbana, and this was tons cheaper at the time. I don't see this hardly any more in the stores out in the wild, but I'm pretty sure you can still order it offline. If you can get your hands on this, I'm telling you guys, if you like the original Dolce & Gabbana, you will like this. This is a great smelling fragrance. Smells amazing. One of the best smelling fragrances I have in my collection. And performance on it is decent. It is decent. I haven't worn this in several years, but if I can remember, yes, I said haven't worn it in several years. Shoot me. Man, it smells so good. But performance on this bad boy was good. I liked it. Liked it a lot. I know. Pretty sure I got at least 2 hours of projection out of it, with between 4 to 6 hours of longevity, and that's about all I can get on my skin. But I love this stuff. It smells good. Perry Ellis Portfolio Green. And the last one from the house of Perry Ellis that doesn't get a lot of talk, that you guys should really be talking about it, and it's from the Portfolio line as well, and this is Perry Ellis Portfolio Black. And I think they've changed the Portfolio bottles. I think now they come with a top that lifts off. Bottle looks similar, but... Hold on, somebody. Hello? I'm shooting a video. What's up? All right. I hate you. Oh, cheap scent column. It's cheapo. Perry Ellis Portfolio. Yes, it looks like a cell phone, but boy, does it smell good. And this is Portfolio Black. And this is, man, I want to say this is a clone of 1 million. It's very spicy. Very, very sweet, spicy. Definitely a poor man's club banger scent. If you've been looking for a clone of 1 million, yeah, it just smells good. Nice, spicy, masculine, definitely a club banger. This is definitely a crowd pleasing scent. Strong. This is not for the office, maybe not even for a date, hanging out with the fellas, going to the club, something where you want to draw attention to yourself. I think this will definitely do it. This Perry Ellis Portfolio Black. Oh, man. Great smelling fragrance. Love the way it smells. Spicy, sweet, club banger, fall, early spring, wintertime scent right here. All right, guys. Again, this video has been 5 fragrances from the house of Perry Ellis that nobody's talking about that I think you guys should pay attention to. One last time, Perry Ellis 360 White. I'm pretty sure this is called Noir, but on the bottle it says 360 Collection. I think this is Perry Ellis 360 Noir is what that's called. If I'm wrong, someone just correct me, it'll be fine. Perry Ellis 360 Reserve, nice, masculine, classy type of scent. Old school vibe, like Dolce & Gabbana, the original. Perry Ellis Portfolio Green. And a club banger, sweet, spicy scent. Perry Ellis Portfolio Black. Alright guys, you know what to do. If you have any familiarity with these fragrances, be sure to leave it in the comments below. Also like, share, and subscribe. Let me know what your favorite fragrance from the house of Perry Ellis is, if you have one. If you don't have one, you know, maybe you should check this out. Check some of these out. That smells just like 1 million. My goodness. That's crazy. But anyway, guys, I'm going to get off here. I hope everybody's having a great Tuesday and staying safe, washing your hands and all that stuff. Until next time, guys. Peace.